just like the ones I used to know. Where the treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Hello again, it's me, Hat Man. Now, it's just gone 12 midday here in Lincoln, and in a couple of hours from now, the Lincolnshire Christmas market should have started. You can't see it, but the cathedral's over there, and up around the cathedral and the castle square and in the castle, there'd have been hundreds of stands and Christmas marketeers and thousands of visitors to this city. But yesterday, the organisers, on the advice of the police and health and safety people, have cancelled for the first time in 28 years the Lincoln Christmas market. And it's all because of what some are calling this white mare. Yeah, white mare, because it's caused gridlock in the city, in Lincoln City, and I'm sure in many parts of not only this county, but also in many parts of the country, and they're suffering down in the southeast. And it's affected all the transport links as well as lots of other activities. So, you know, rail, buses, even the airports are closed down, Gatwick's closed down. Now this is the fourth day of the big freeze or the big whiteout, whatever you want to call it. And temperatures are set tonight to drop to below minus 10 degrees centigrade. We've been having record temperature lows, that is, and of course record snow. I'm standing now here in about a foot of snow. I can't remember snow like this, and I can see my camera lens getting covered in snow in a good 30 years, 40 years maybe. 1963 I remember trudging through the snow like this on my way to school. But talking about schools, over 600, oh, I'm exaggerating now, over 400 schools in this county have been shut over the past couple of days because transport's been disrupted, and of course many people who expect their children to be in school have had to take time off work, and they say the economic impact of that could be as much as £1.2 billion a day. That's of course nationwide. Now, if you can still see me for the snow building up on my camera, I mean, that is a huge effect. That's going to be personally damaging to people and families who are going to lose income. And also, of course, with the Christmas market here in Lincoln City, a great tradition and a great money earner, it's going to be very damaging to businesses in Lincoln City who reckon to earn, you know, tens of millions of pounds extra from the 10,000 visitors or more that come to the city, especially for the Christmas market. So it's a big tragedy for them, and my sympathies go to them. I don't know if I put a jinx on the Christmas celebrations, because I don't celebrate Christmas, as you well know. And I was planning to go up to the Christmas market and do some busking, you know, and play a few songs, earn a few pennies, and also entertain the punters. Why not? But it seems like, you know, higher powers had different ideas, and the Christmas market's been whited out. And you'd think it's ironic, really, isn't it? Christmas market, you couldn't want more than a lovely Christmas setting than this, and snow and whatnot. But no, it's put the kibosh on it, and it's threatening businesses in this city. So I'm very sympathetic towards them. I'm very sorry that their Christmas is really going to be white-outed or blight-outed, however you want to put it. Bye for now.